Hi guys! Thanks for tuning in. I'm Raquel.
I'm Jake.
And this is Don't You Know? So, I don't know why I wave every time I say hey. They can't see me.
It's good form.
And I talk with my hands, and I'm just so...
You need a television show.
We do have a YouTube channel, though.
That's true.
So, let's go ahead and, I guess, do updates with our lives / media. Let's do both.
Okay.
Do you want to go first? Do you want me to go first?
I gotta think about what I've done.
Okay, so I guess I'm going first then. Let's see here. What have I done? I haven't really done much, honestly, because I live in California, and so everything is being shut down again. Yay!
Bummer.
So, let's see. Now, film-wise, movie-wise... TV shows. I finally finished Vampire Diaries and the original.
Wow, that's a long time coming.
Yes, I am so happy. I was okay with the ending for both of them. They weren't exactly, like, my happy ending for them, but they were still, you know, at least good endings. I kind of, like, in Vampire Diaries, I kind of, like, spoiler alert, guys. Don't listen to this if you haven't seen it, I guess. So you have, like, kind of two kind of main girls. Well, there's, like, three main girls in the show. And, so you have, like, Elena and you have Bonnie, and then you have Caroline. Well, Caroline was my favorite. And she did not get a happy ending, really, at the end. It was actually Elena. Because Caroline and Elena both liked the brothers. One of the brother dies. I don't really have a favorite when it comes down to the brothers, but out of the two girls, I had a favorite. And so I was kind of sad that her love was the one that died. But it made sense at the end because the other two wanted to live a human life. If Caroline and her love lived a vampire life, then they would never, you know, get to see each other again, basically, once the two humans died, is the thing. So the way that they had it was that Stefan died. Well, then eventually when Elena and Damon died of old age, he got to see his brother again. Whereas if he was the one that died, then Stefan would never see his brother again because he's a vampire.
Unless,
of course, he, like, met the ultimate death. And then the original, two of my favorite characters died.
Oh, that always stings a little.
And I knew they were going to die because I've seen Legacies. So I knew they were going to die.
They might have just moved away.
No, they died because the two of my favorite characters, one, I like their characters, but two, I also like them because my favorite character in Legacy, that's her parents. And it's very obvious that they're dead because it's mentioned throughout the whole show consistently that her parents are dead.
Yeah, she wears black in every episode and acts just completely rebellious. It's like that, I saw a sketch once where they, hey, you can't hit that building with a hammer. Yeah, I can. My parents are dead. Oh.
Actually, nah, she is like the savior kind of. She was a kind of a loner because, you know, a lot of people that she loved had died. She kind of was more like, because she kind of grew up, her family was not the best, like, at all. Like, they did a lot of bad things. And so they kind of pressured her to be like the good of the family, to build a new legacy that's not built on blood. So she kind of has like a hero complex.
I gotcha.
But she's still my favorite character, and so when her two, not going to lie, I did tear up a couple of times in the series when the mom died, and then a little bit when the father died too, and so I would have been a lot happier if they had both lived, but for the most part was still pretty good last season.
All right, obviously this is spoiler alert territory, but how'd they go?
Okay, so I hate how the mom died, actually. I completely hate it. I think it was really, really stupid. So, the vampires can't walk in the sun.
Yeah.
Unless they have a special magic ring, which they call a daylight ring.
Okay.
And her mom is a hybrid. She was a werewolf, then she had, like, a hybrid blood in her. When she died, because when you turn into a vampire, it's because you have vampire blood in your system, and when you die, you become a vampire, you wake back up. If you drink blood, human blood, then your transition's complete. If you don't drink human blood when you wake back up, then you just die again.
Okay, so she walked in the sun and burnt to a crisp?
No.
Oh.
So, her mother is a hybrid, so she's aware, because she was a werewolf, she had special hybrid blood in her system when she died, and then she had it. So she's a hybrid. Since she's a hybrid, she doesn't need a daylight ring to go out into the sun.
Alright.
Well, she was captured. Her daughter was doing everything that she could to find her, and ended up trusting a guy.
Never do that.
Exactly. Was supposed to help her with something. Come, and he leads her to a building where they're supposed to meet a witch to help, and she sees her mother there, come to find out the guy is the one that kidnapped her mother. Now, the thing with him is that he's basically been brainwashed by his mother. So he thinks that all that they're trying to do is, they're kind of like purist vampires. And since she's a hybrid and the mom's a hybrid, they're not pure.
They're racist.
Yeah. So he was led to believe that what they were trying to do was just make them bind their wolf, which would make them full vampire. That's what he thought they were going to do. His mother just wants to kill them. And so they're like, no, don't trust your mother. She's going to kill us. And he's like, no, they just want to bind it. And so the mother was like, okay, fine, bind my werewolf. So she goes and binds her werewolf, but they have a plan and they almost escape, except for the fact that since the mother had her werewolf bound, that meant she was a full vampire, which meant she couldn't walk out in the sun without a daylight ring.
And it caught her off guard.
It's the middle of the day.
Dang.
No, she knew this. Hope was like, you knew this. And she was like, yes, just go. Just leave, because Hope doesn't need a daylight ring. Just go, Hope. Bring back help. Just go. I want you safe, because that's what a mother's supposed to do. They spent the whole time arguing. And then eventually, the guy's mother shows up, and come to find out, yes, she wants to kill them. He's like, I thought we were just binding the wolves. And they're like, no, because every spell has a loophole so they can unbind their wolf and then they'll be unpure again. So the best solution is just to kill them. So they go through this whole struggle. Hope ends up unconscious. She's fighting the mother. Now, since she's not a hybrid anymore, she's not as strong as the mother is. And so she's not doing so well. And Klaus, who is Hope's father, shows up, and he's original and a hybrid. Ain't no one stopping him. So he comes to show up, but then his brother, who has memory loss, fights him and therefore stops him. So the mother has, like,
yeah,
is losing, and the other girl has her hand in her chest with her heart, which basically means she's gonna die. So what she does in the last attempt to save her daughter is she tears off the other girl's finger that has her daylight ring. She throws both of them out into the yard, basically through the door, front door, and out into the yard, and they burst and they both die.
So she was burnt to a crisp.
Yeah, they both were. So my whole issue with
all this is a long answer. There's a very lot of background. There's a lot of background info here.
Yes, it is. So my whole issue, though, is that they could have gone away before the mother came. I mean, the reason why is, yes, she can't go into the sun without a daylight ring. But they had knocked unconscious, well, killed, but, like, not really, really killed. Like, with the vampires, you can snap their neck, and so they'll die, but they just come back to life because you have to stake them or pull out their heart. So they snapped his neck. The other guy. So my thought process was, yes, you don't have a daylight ring to go out into the sun, but that guy over there does. The one that you just snapped his neck. He's unconscious. Why didn't you just steal his daylight ring? Then you both could have just left.
Yeah.
And so that was my whole issue with her death was, like, they both could have lived. It's kind of like the whole Titanic thing. They both could have fit on that door.
Right. Plot hole. Well, it's better in the book.
Okay. Anyways, that's it. You go. Oh, well, actually, no, one more quick thing. I'm just gonna say it really quickly, I guess, kind of. Another show that I have been watching that I didn't think I would be that interested into, but now I'm kind of interested. It's a reality show. It's called Too Hot to Handle. It's on Netflix, and basically it is all these guys and girls. They're taken to, well, not like a lot, but it's like a, you know, a decent group. And they're taken to an island. It's basically a resort, and it's awesome, and blah, 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 blah. And they're all, like, very, like, sexualized. And they basically are told they're not allowed to have sex or kiss or anything like that.
No PDA.
Yeah.
I agree with that.
And they're told that they can't do that. And every time they break the rules, they lose money. And if they can go without whatever, they win $100,000. Now, if anyone breaks the rules, you lose money based on what the offense was.
Okay. So, like, if it's, like, a high five, they get a buck, but if it's
it's like only like kissing and anything beyond kissing. So like cuddling is fine and all that stuff, but
wait, cuddling is beyond kissing. I would kiss somebody once before I cuddle them. Nah, I don't know. It depends. It's all circumstantial.
Well, they allow cuddling. Anyways, so I didn't think I would really find that interesting. I was like, that's kind of stupid. But the thing actually is, this is almost like a sex rehab, like resort, basically.
Okay.
What's going on. So it makes it a little bit more interesting.
I don't know what sex rehab means, and I hope I never know. But carry on, please.
Okay, so basically these people have to learn how to actually make meaningful connections because they don't do that. They're just basically one-night stands and that's it. So they're learning to actually form emotional connection.
I was thinking they were like sexual offenders, like registered with the state or something.
No.
Okay, that's a whole different show.
Yeah, no, like half of, like pretty much this whole show.
They're just like playboys and women of the night, to put it politely.
Yeah, it wasn't even 24 hours and they're already, all of them were like, oh my god, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I can't make it. And I was like, it's only been 24, it hasn't even been 24 hours. And like within the 24 hours, someone had already kissed and lost $3,000.
$3,000 for a kiss? No, I would never. That, I mean, there have been more expensive kisses, but I'm not paying $3,000 for a kiss. No way.
It's crazy. And then, spoiler alert, whatever, it happens like the second episode. These two girls, like, they basically like kind of decide to get revenge on the whole group because they were like calling them out and blah 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 blah. And they're like, you know what? Fine. And so what they did was they turned around and they kissed each other just to make the whole group lose $3,000.
That's funny.
I don't know. You watch it and you're just like, these people, some of them are really stupid. And you just gotta like,
that makes good television though sometimes.
Yeah. Well, I mean, who really wants to watch the smart person on TV? That's the History Channel.
I know, that's why I've never been on TV. So, we've watched, talking about media, we watched a movie called Sublime. Have you ever heard of this one?
I have heard of it. I actually haven't seen it, though.
It's like a, it like blurs the line between psychological thriller and like absolute horror thriller kind of thing. It's really good. The premise is, without spoiling anything, a guy goes to get a routine colonoscopy, as you do in your 30s or 40s, I don't know, and there's, things go wrong, and that's all I'm gonna say. And there are complications, well, that's not all I'm gonna say. There are complications that lead to more complications, and ultimately it's a very, very, very wild ride, and it's done very well, and it's completely disturbing, and you know when, like, when you're watching something and you have to, like, get up and, like, flex and you're making that, like, bleh, bleh, like, expression all over? It did that to me more than a few times. So it's pretty good. I recommend it.
Cool.
And then we also watched 13 Ghosts again. Have you seen that one? It's a little lighter. It's about 13 ghosts in a house.
No, I don't think I've ever seen that.
The family inherits.
I don't think I've even heard of that.
Imagine the family inherits a haunted house from a long-lost relative.
That's one of my fears of looking for a place. I'm afraid I'll get, a haunted apartment, and then you're stuck with, a year lease. And you're like, I don't know what to do.
Yeah, right. You're real cheap. They have to disclose when somebody's, met their maker in that premises.
Well, good. But that doesn't mean that it's not haunted.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Okay, well.
All right.
I didn't say any updates with the podcast. I, skipped right over it. I am so sorry. So, as of right now, we don't have any new listeners in any new countries or states. But we have a new leader that we have never had in the lead before.
Oh.
It is Illinois.
Illinois. Top dog.
Mm-hmm. I didn't say the S this time. Aren't you proud of me?
I am, yeah. I was like going in my head. I'm like, okay, she's probably right. I have to make sure I don't mess it up.
Okay, and that's it. So let's get on to our topic because this is kind of a long opening now.
Yeah, I know. Goodness. It's good though.
We like long openings here at Don't You Know?
Yeah,
don't
I mean, everyone's quarantined. We get a little extra on the front end.
So for today's topic, I figured, why not social media? So, I mean, it's air. Everyone's getting really into it now that they're quarantined and having to use it a lot more now.
Yeah, everyone's vlogging and doing all the things.
So I think that before we even start to discuss it, I think we should kind of not necessarily give a definition of social media, but kind of say what we're thinking when we're talking about social media. Because there's probably some stuff that maybe isn't really, like, maybe is social media, but when we think about social media, we might not think about that.
Yeah,
or maybe there's something that we think of as social media, but it's not really. Like YouTube. Do you consider that social media? I think it is, but...
Yeah, it's kind of... It's like splitting hairs at that point. Because technically, yes, it is. You're being social and there's media. So at, like, the most general terms... Like, yeah, it is. But I would see it as more of an entertainment, like, subsect. Like, when I'm commenting on YouTube, I'm not commenting as me. I'm commenting as a character that is my YouTube, like, account, you know?
Yeah. But you do have a lot of people who do blogs and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And that would be about their person. That's what I'm saying. Like, let's kind of maybe, like, we don't have to give every single example that's out there. But as we're doing this podcast, what are some social media ones that you're thinking about?
Primarily, I guess, Facebook wins. That's primary social media. Secondary, I guess, Twitter. And those are the top two for me. I can't even think of a third one, honestly. They just dominate. I guess Snapchat counts. And then there's stuff like Snapchat and TikTok. That's more. So those are more like person-to-world kind of social media, you know? And then there's like person-to-person, which is like Snapchat. And I guess Messenger, which is like a subsect of Facebook or whatever. I think I said subsect twice over here. I'm just using my big words. You know, seven letters. I think that... Oh, Instagram's a big one, but that's another, like, individual to world. I've always been told that social media is all about, and a lot of things are about, audience and purpose. Like, what are you saying and to whom are you saying it? And I think social media is a big way to go about that. Whether it's, like, person to person or person to the masses or a corporation to the masses, that's a big, like, part of, see, I said part, not subsect, of social media that we'll probably talk about. It's a long story long. It depends.
So when I say social media, like, most of probably what I'll be talking about will be focused probably like Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat.
How many of these do you have? Do you have all of these that you've listed?
Yes.
Okay.
That's why I'm listing them.
I have an Instagram, but I barely use it. I have a Facebook, but I only sort of use it. I use it a bit, actually. Snapchat, I barely use. I only use it to talk to like one person.
Me.
Okay, two people.
Jacob, I wasn't included.
I'm sorry.
You need to talk to a lot more people because we have our college buddies group that you send stuff to.
If I'm going to talk to you, it's through text. Like, that's my primary. And then it's going to be Snapchat.
For the longest time, Adriana and Lindsay, that's like the only way we were talking, was sending Snapchats to each other.
Nice. It's a good way to do it. Snapchat's fun. And I'm sure TikTok's fun.
It's something
fun,
like, it's really quick to keep in touch with someone.
Yeah. And the filters are just great, aren't they?
Yeah. I'd love taking a picture in Snapchat first instead of using my phone camera. Which apparently they're going to change it with the new iPhone. Because one of the reasons why people like to use the Snapchat one versus their phone is because they like to use the front view picture. The front view camera. But it like flips it.
Yeah.
Whereas Snapchat doesn't do that.
Yeah, there's a big difference between that because it's what you see in the mirror and that's what you like versus what you see in pictures.
So.
No, I think you got it backwards. I think Snapchat does mirror it.
When you take the picture with the camera, not with Snapchat, it flips your picture.
No, Snapchat does not flip it. I just took a picture.
Yeah, Snapchat doesn't. The camera will. When you use your regular camera and not using Snapchat, it will flip it with the iPhone. The iPhone does that.
Yeah, and I've seen that before. I think Instagram does it too.
And so with the new iPhone, they're going to have it where you can choose to turn that off.
Yeah, I think it's a common feature. I think I've seen that before. I don't know. Okay, but that's not social media. That's pictures.
Yeah, but Snapchat was.
Oh, yeah.
Don't you know that if you want the best picture, you take it with Snapchat first?
Snapchat's pretty good. I feel like, okay, so we can talk about cameras real briefly. The front-facing and the rear-facing. My best pictures are with my rear-facing camera, and I have to be, like, a couple feet away. Now, maybe that says something about me. I'm best viewed from a distance. But I think it's also my front-facing camera. My previous phone was too narrow. Because I've seen, there are compilation images of, like GIFs and stuff, where people get the same picture with a bunch of different focal lens, I don't remember the term, like lens diameters or whatever, and they just look terrible in one, and they look okay in the other or whatever, or they look really good in one. And the same person, it's just the camera, you know? You have to have a good camera. I think that's why modern cameras have like 4 or 5 lenses on the back. My new one has 4 lenses on the back.
I have 2 cameras on the back.
I'm not trying to flex. It just does a good deal.
I take really good portrait pictures. Okay, you know, speaking about, because you're speaking about like cameras and stuff. I don't know why I was thinking. You know what? I don't know how this goes from what you're saying, but I just started to think about it. What do you think is like an appropriate age for like social media? Oh, what I was thinking was because, you know, don't you know, social media can be dangerous. You're putting out personal information and it could like potentially lead people back to you.
Yeah, you need to be really careful. I always think about the best place to do this is like you see people on Facebook or whatever. And if you like click a meme video or something and people will be arguing back and forth, they'll be saying like these terrible things. And you always look and you're like, man, I'm just like 2 clicks away from seeing your family. Like that's it. Don't argue on Facebook. Don't you know? Don't argue on Facebook because you never know which guy's crazy and is coming for you.
Yeah.
You're way easier to find than you think you are. Oh, that's so dark. I don't mean...
And you also need to be careful what you put on your Facebook too, because for 2 reasons. 1, some background checks actually allow to have access to your big Facebook, so you could lose a job for that. And 2, because some people, that's what they do. Like, they look in your Facebook and all that stuff and, like, see all your personal information and then use that personal information to answer, like, security questions and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah, for sure. That's why you should always do, like, obscure security questions. Don't do, like, oh, what high school did you go to? You are the 1 Google search away from most people finding that out. You got to do, like, what was my best friend in 2nd grade sister's pet's name.
But I can't even remember that.
Yeah, I'm just joking. That's extreme.
Oh, I do like... I'm not going to say what I do.
Yeah, good point. I was in a lab once with some people back at school. And somebody was like talking with some friends. And they were like, oh yeah. They're like, I know I shouldn't, but I use the same password for everything. They're like, I know that's like my first mistake. And I was like, yeah, and your second mistake is telling everyone that you do that. And like everyone busted out laughing because the person was like, yeah, you're right. It was like a 1-2 punch. It was pretty funny. Don't you know, go change your passwords. There are websites you can use, which there's one, it's called Have I Been Pwned, if I remember it properly, something like that. And you can go in and search your password. Now, this might be a scam. You just type in all your passwords and then anyone that has a keylogger on your computer. But if they got a keylogger on your computer, they've already got all your passwords. Anyway, you go there and it'll tell you if your password has ever been hacked or if it's like in any databases of like, because some hackers will do like common password things and there'll just be like 10,000 million passwords. They just run them through real quickly. And if you're on those lists, because the good guys can get those lists too. If you're on that, they'll be like, you need to change it. It should be a long passphrase.
Okay, so age then. I don't know. Because like, it just seems like, I don't know, to me, like when I was a kid, I did have like, my parents tested me on Facebook. They had someone that I didn't know, like add me as a friend on Facebook. And I added them and I would have been kidnapped. I would
nice.
Been, I'm not gonna lie, I would have been kidnapped.
Kind of like kidnapped per se,
I learned after that. And that's I funny. Never, now I don't add anyone I don't know on my Facebook.
Yeah, you really should. But I learned. That's spooky. No, it is so spooky because a lot of the time it's like, imagine you're swimming in the ocean and you're just la 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 la, just swimming, and then you're just hoping there's no giant shark there just coming up to eat you. Like, there are giant sharks in the ocean, you're just hoping they're not where you're at, you know?
Mm-hmm. And you're hoping that you're not bleeding too.
I mean, there are those people who say like, oh, you shouldn't put anything on the internet, like at all about yourself. You should just stay off it. And in a way, I think they're paranoid, and I hope I'm right, but I know there's no way they could possibly get bitten if they're not swimming in the internet, swimming in the ocean, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's impossible. You can't get bit by a shark if you don't go swimming. It's impossible. You can't get cyber hacked and have all your life ruined or whatever if you don't put any of your life on the internet. That's wise, but I mean, who does that though?
Yeah, but see, like at the same time, what makes it hard with social media is that you don't really see who's on the other side.
Yeah, and that's a big thing too, is these people who, you meet somebody online, you start talking, you think they're the best person in the world, you fall in love. You go and meet each other, and then you get married online, and then you finally move in, and then you realize he's got a terrible temper, or he's actually, like, addicted to cocaine while he's on computer or whatever. Like, you never know people online, and that's a big thing. Don't you know? You have no idea who they are. If they control the information flow, they could be Gandhi, and that's all they're letting you see. Don't get fooled.
That's a good question, though. Is online dating a social media.
Yes, but it's not...
I didn't think about it like that, but, I mean, I can see it.
I mean, that's as social as you can be, is trying to, you know, go meet people.
Sure.
But it's different, though, because I feel like... All right, so there's, like, your public face and your private face. They say that you wear masks when you're with your friends and when you're with your family and when you're with yourself. I feel like on Facebook, that's your public face, and that's... For me, I'll post stuff on other apps that I won't post on Facebook. Nothing that bad or anything, but just things that I wouldn't want on my public Facebook. My public Facebook is squeaky clean, and it's all good stuff, and because that's what I think it should be. Yeah, that's what everybody does. But
I'm the same way. Like on Facebook, I don't post stuff like I think I've started to do it now, but when I was like in college and stuff like that, I wouldn't post like drinks and stuff like that on Facebook. Yeah. But I would post it on like Instagram, or I would post it on like Snapchat, but like on Facebook, not really.
Right, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And there's also, don't you know, the more anonymity you have, it just as people, the looser you're going to be with how you carry yourself, you know? And so like you might make a raunchy joke on YouTube that you wouldn't make on Facebook. And if you don't have to log in to make a comment, you can say whatever you want. You know what I mean? And that's why sites like 4chan or whatever, where you don't have to log in, are just like wild west of the internet.
Okay. I feel like we need more don't you knows, because there's not a lot of discussions. We've gone on a couple tangents.
All right, let's talk about emojis.
Okay, what about emojis?
Do you use them? I think everybody, if you don't use them, you're behind the curve here. I think everybody uses them. It's a good way because you can't, when you're speaking, you can do tone. I'm doing tone right now, you know, as you go and you carry like the cadence of your voice or whatever. Like when I'm doing a joke, like if you're face to face, you can wink or you can like do your shoulder or something kind of weird to let them know you're joking. In text, you can't do that. You got to put an emoji. And social media is like that too.
Ha, ha, ha. Or JK.
Yeah, or slash S for sarcasm or whatever.
I've never seen that one.
I think we talked before about a girl who made a joke as she went onto a plane. And it was just a tongue-in-cheek satirical joke, in bad taste, admittedly. But when she landed, it was like everybody doxed her. Because it was pretty racist.
I don't remember this.
It wasn't like a friend of ours or anything. It was just like in the internet somewhere.
No, but I don't remember.
Oh, it wasn't that big of a story. I guess what I'm saying is if she would have put a winky face, she would have been fine. No, that's not really... You shouldn't publish anything on the internet that you wouldn't really want put on the news, you know? That's kind of a good rule.
Unfortunately, though, too, like, have to always be kind of careful because everything can also be taken, like, a different way, too.
Yeah, people can get one tweet and ignore the rest, or, like, you get your first tweet, blows up, and it makes you a monster. And then your second tweet where you clarify what you said and what you actually meant to say, or the typo, but then it's too late.
But it's too late by that point, unfortunately.
All right, what do you think about corporate? Speaking of people that mess up and it goes big, what do you think about corporate, like, Twitters and stuff? Do you like that, or does that bother you? Is that just advertising for free?
It depends on what they're using. If we're saying, like, for Twitter or, like, for Instagram or whatever, it depends on what they're using it for. Like, I follow some corporate stuff on Twitter and on Instagram, and because, one, sometimes they give giveaways, and I love that, obviously.
Events.
Yeah. Two, like, some of the stores and stuff like that, I follow them so they can see what's new in their store. So I might be waiting for something, and I see. Okay, you have it.
But is that social, or is that consumerist? Because when I'm going on to find out what my friends are doing on the weekend, I don't really care. I almost use more explicit language. I don't really care about what what's going on sale at whatever store, you know? That bothers me.
Yeah, I mean, it can be.
I don't come there for that.
The thing is, you don't have to follow those corporations if you're not interested
in them. That's a good point. It is an opt-in kind of thing. If you like them, you can do it. That's for sure.
Because, like, it's not really ads. You're purposely picking these companies because maybe they're company that you are interested in, like, giveaways for them, or which I do think is a social kind of media thing.
Yeah, and it's not all companies. Like, if there's a company that I like, on it, like, first thing that comes to mind is Panera Bread. I get them every day, pretty much. Like, I might follow them on Twitter or something. I don't have a Twitter, but... I do have a Twitter. I don't use it.
If you did follow them, then you could possibly find out when they would have, like, specials.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, with Starbucks, like, I have their app, which is why, and I also have their emailing list. So when they have things like buy one, get one free or whatever, I get notifications for it.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be the same way on those things. Another thing, though, too, is some corporations, I don't know, I can't remember. I think it is, like, verified, but you have, like, Wendy's Twitter that turns around and, like, responds back to comments, and it's, like, very, like, sarcastic and witty about it.
Yeah,
and
there are a handful of them that really stand out that are like that.
So I think corporations are perfectly fine having those things, as long as it remains that you can choose to follow them or not.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you choose to follow them, then you are accepting that you will get some ads.
Yeah.
Because that's what they use it for. They want to, of course, make money.
Right, of course.
They have to pay for whoever is running their Instagram.
Yeah, money keeps the lights on, keeps the internet bill, keeps the hamburgers frying.
Yeah, because I'm pretty sure the CEO is not the one that's sitting behind a dish just chilling on Instagram. Oh, I'm having this new product, so time to put it on Instagram. No. So, I sounded very country when I said that.
Okay. What are your favorite kinds of things to post? I wouldn't call what you post memes. I would post them like, they're not really memes. You like stuff about pop culture. Just like stuff, like discussion stuff.
Yes.
And like, you post a lot of stuff with Avatar and like anime and things.
Yes. I like to do pop culture kind of stuff. More like, I'm trying to think of the right word for it. I don't think pun is the right word, but kind of jokes that are for more of the pop kind of nerds.
Yeah,
they would
references.
Get it.
References. You have to be in the group to get the joke.
Yeah, basically, that's what I like to do. And since a lot of my friends are either, they do really like anime, or they also really like Avatar, they like superheroes, they do kind of get those jokes. Sometimes my family likes them and stuff like that. I don't think they actually get the joke, but they like it anyway.
Sometimes you, might not see the show or whatever, but you can still kind of get the joke and they're funny or whatever. I do that with a lot of car stuff. It's kind of the same thing. You have to know a little bit about cars to get the joke sometimes.
And so that's what I usually like to do with Facebook. Sometimes I'll post other pictures or whatever. I don't take too many pictures of myself. My dad's really big about like tagging himself at places, and I'm not too big about that.
I don't
unless
do that.
I'm like, so on occasion I will do it maybe, but not for most part. A lot of times when I'm using Facebook, I'm like sharing like the different funny pictures.
It has to be like someplace special, like Pacific Ocean or something, like when we went on to LA or something like that.
When we go to Japan, I'm going to post probably tons of pictures on Facebook.
Yeah. I might do lunch or something, like, as I'm leaving. I don't want it to be, like, I don't know.
I probably will post a lot of pictures on Instagram and Facebook for a couple of reasons. One, because I'm excited that I'm there. And it's, like, kind of, like, you know, share that excitement with your friends and family. But also, you never know. Someone might be like, oh, you're in Japan. Make sure you check out this place. And two, because I'm not going to want to keep all those photos on my phone forever. So by having them in two other locations, I still always have those photos, even though they're not on my phone anymore.
Yeah.
Like the photos of when you came out here. I don't have them on my phone anymore, but they're on my Facebook, so I can still see them.
Right.
Now for my Instagram, now that one is like a mixed varieties. I do a lot of giveaway stuff. They require you to repost. I do a lot of my Funko Pops. I post those pictures. Like I said, that's where I post a lot of my like drinks and stuff like that I might have. If I have like a special drink at a restaurant, like a little fancy one, I won't like post like a picture of a screwdriver usually, but
right. Yeah, I try not to do specialty pictures or something. Try to keep that sort of stuff up. If it would get YouTube demonetized, I don't normally put it on my on my social media. I don't drink too often either.
That's what I do for that. Snapchat usually is kind of like just random stuff.
That's usually just me and my girlfriend or you.
Yeah, I will send a picture of something that I'm like, I think that's cool and I want to take a picture, but it's not like something that necessarily I want to put on Facebook. Like not interesting enough to where I would put it on Facebook, but interesting enough to be like, hey, I want to send this to specific friends, you know? Like, hey, look what I'm eating, because I know that, like, we all go to Taco Bell or something like that, or, like, something that I know we all do, and I'll send it to you guys. Like, sometimes, my drinks, I'll send it to you guys only, because it's, like, that was kind of what we used to, like, hang out and talk about and do.
I get you.
So, or if I think I saw, like, this one thing about, like, Georgia, and so I'll take a picture and send it to you guys, because you guys are my friends from Georgia.
Right.
So that's what I use mainly Snapchat for. TikTok I mainly use just to watch videos. And that's about it.
Because I'm an old man, I don't have a TikTok. I reject it. That's too Zoomer for me. But honestly, I never even had a Vine. I was already an old man when Vine was out. But now I'm loyal to Vine and I never even had a Vine.
I never had Vine. So, and then I have Twitter, but I don't use Twitter too often. I use it mostly for Funko Pop stuff.
And Don't You Know stuff. You can follow us at Don't You Know.
Yes, but that automatically gets usually updated from Podbean. I do check for notifications. I do, you know, post a couple things here and there. But for my personal Twitter, I don't usually do anything other than, like, repost, maybe giveaways.
Uh-huh.
I use it mostly for Funko Pops. They have a couple of notifications for when stuff goes, like, restocks. So I have, you know, alerts for when certain Funko Pops are restocked.
That's all consumerism stuff. That's not social.
When?
That's buy, consume, obey.
The two slowly mesh together.
Yeah, that's what they want. They go, oh, yeah,
well, it makes
we're your
sense.
Friends. Just let us have all your money. We're going to sell you plastic crap while you lose all your...
It
every time, every dollar that you earn is time.
Sense. It makes sense. It's a network. Why would you not capitalize on a network?
No, I'm just joking. You're exactly right. I mean, I'm getting free coffee right now because I'm on the email list. Our email is social media? Kind of. Technically, I guess.
Huh.
Our email, I guess email newsletters kind of are.
I guess so. See, that's what the social media is so hard. I figured it'd be an interesting topic to do.
But that's for me, like honestly, if I'm, I do not mind corporate emails. I hate seeing corporate stuff on Facebook. Twitter's okay, but email me. Keep my business to email, you know. If you're more interested in my dollar than my person, then you belong in email and not on Facebook.
Well, but see, what's nice is when it gives you the option to choose what you're seeing. I don't like it when it gives you ads and stuff like that.
Yeah. There are too many ads on Facebook now, and they're getting to be too many ads on Reddit, too.
Yeah, that's one thing I don't like, is when they give you ads, but they don't, like, ever seem to, like, verify with these places.
Oh, it's the worst. It's like every every fifth post is an ad. It is a scam. You're a number and you're a dollar, don't forget it.
No, I meant, like, these places are, like, straight up, like, fraud. They don't actually, like, send
you
stuff.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Like, it's like they don't,
I'm
they
getting
just
really
like,
hipster
oh.
Nihilist over here.
Yes, you are. You are a hipster.
You knew this
no,
was going
to
happen.
No, I'm talking about like, okay, so I've ordered a couple of things from ads. I've been suckered into that.
No, sometimes an ad hits.
Some of, like, at least two of them I've had to, one of them I have a case open in PayPal because I never got the item. It's just, it's not coming. It's been a few months. It's just not coming. There's another one that, like, in both this one and the other one, I, like, sent an email to the company and then it came back undeliverable. So obviously it's a scam. Another one I had to, like, dispute it and I got it back on my credit card. But, like, it's like, doesn't, like, Facebook doesn't do any type of background on any of these things that they're doing.
No,
ads.
Remember,
they're just
they
like,
even,
oh, yeah, it's for money.
They got really kind of in, not trouble. They were in the news because back when the elections went and they were like, oh, this ad that you're running is literally a lie. And they're like, oh, well, we're not going to curate our ads.
But it's like getting worse. Like almost like they're like spitting in the face because they had that issue.
No, they're just,
it's
they're
like
just
so
churning
bad
out.
Now.
They just got the money making turn up to 11. They're like YouTube. I saw this one video. It was like, okay, so here's the thing. This is kind of dark.
Don't you know we hate ads on our social media?
Yeah, if you follow us, we believe in you. anyway, this guy made a video about how, like, oh, there's a bunch of bad people on this website. This website needs to be taken down. And then the video was a bunch of proof on how, like, there's these really bad people on this one website. And then the bad people went to the video and said, hey, this video defames us. And then YouTube's like, oh, we're taking the video down. And that's what happens when you get these things that are just turned up, just they're just a big machine, just chugging and chugging and chugging along. And it's just the big stuff over the little stuff. You can't forget about the little stuff. I know it's hard to process every single person that does like a copyright claim, but there are a few that really need attention, I guess. I don't know where I'm going with this one. We should probably wrap up. I'm in big time rambling mode for like 2 bits now.
Okay, well, let's wrap up then. We hope you guys enjoyed this episode on social media. By the way, we have social media if you would like to follow us on Twitter.
Good segue.
At Don't You Know Pod, or send us an email at don'tyouknowpod@gmail.com. We even have a YouTube, which is not Don't You Know. I mean, you can search for it and find a playlist for the Don't You Know episodes, but it's actually called Off Missile
Off
Production.
Off Field Missile Productions.
Yes.
Like you're shooting at the training fields and with your missile, and it was off the field. It's a big play on a few words.
Anyways, I'll add a link in below if you're interested in our YouTube channel. We have a couple of things. We have, you know, the Don't You Know podcast. We have Don't You Draw, which we draw stupid stuff in 10 seconds and compete to see who wins. Usually it's Jacob.
Yeah.
We have July's episode up now, and the voting's going to be coming to an end soon, so get your votes in for that.
I got a YouTube channel. I'm trying to get them videos out, new games and stuff.
Yeah, I may include Jacob's YouTube video account, maybe. And then we also, on our channel, we also have Rocky Doesn't Game, which is featuring me trying to play video games.
Yeah, they're fun.
Yes. And we would also greatly appreciate if you shared this episode or our podcast in general, because you know what we didn't talk about is podcasts as social media, but it totally is. And yeah, and follow and subscribe us so that you can get updates when our next episode comes out, because as of right now, we really don't have a schedule. They just come out whenever.
Yeah.
So you want to be in the know.
Right.
Okay. Until next time, guys. See ya.
Bye.